founder of the drone data science company WeDoSky. Our journey started back in 2014 when I was still a drone hobbyist and I was looking for avenues to bring this technology to India. Over the last few years, we've flourished into a company that works with large industries in the solar sector, mining sector, and in the insurance sector. Our partners, Tata, Adani, ACC, most of the larger companies which you would think would be using drone solutions. Along with that, we've been working with the government, helping them better analyze properties on the ground and bring value to the citizens of the country. Investor pitch. Well, that's a point that most entrepreneurs spend a lot of time on. And quite ironically, they spend a lot of time anticipating what needs to go into the investor pitch rather than building the investor pitch. I would partially put the blame on the infinite information that's available on the internet. So you start reading your first 10 articles, and eventually by the time you reach your 12th article, there's an information overload and you actually don't build the pitch in itself. And you struggle to just collate your thoughts and put any sense out of the information that you've read on the internet. So I'll start with sharing some of the inputs that were actually given to me by my investors while we were raising our funds. I remember this candid conversation with our deal leader, Rishan Singh, offline conversation where he quite candidly told me one very interesting thing, that as an investor, he invests into the founder and the founding team. So he said that, hey Jaspreet, while I understand that your business is doing well, the industry is growing, drones would definitely add value to the entire ecosystem eventually, but I'm not investing into all of this. I'm investing into you, which basically means that as an investor, all of my money is just riding on one person or two persons in the organization. That's the founders. So most investors are actually investing into the founders. Why? Because they understand that as the company grows, as the revenue start coming in, a smart founder should ideally pivot and focus on making the business larger. And while that happens, everything that you put into an investor deck, the business plan, the growth plan, the trajectories that you're planning would eventually change. So from an investor's point of view, there will be three or four things that you're actually looking into when you're looking into your day. I would say start with yourself. Start talking about yourself, your accomplishments, your failures, and the learnings that you've had from your failures. Secondly, talk about your team. Get a great team together. Try to get them aligned with what you want to do and give them equity. Keeping control of equity is almost always a bad idea. You want to give it out to the people in the organization who are building the organization with you. So show a great team. Show that you've learned and grown as a person and you have the capability to deliver on the promises that you've given to the investors. And then talk about the industry. So you want to give the investors a confidence that they're investing into an industry that's growing. Why? Because it's always easier to spend downstream instead of upstream. So when the industry is growing, it's easier for a company in that industry to grow as well. So this gives the confidence to the investors that they're investing into a great team and an industry that's going to grow. Along with that, something that really helped us was to highlight the global patterns, which basically means that while we were all globally early stage into this drone industry, there were some great initial examples of companies doing well in the US. So our deck also included a few examples of how American companies were doing really well, providing local solutions that could be replicated in India.